Hey everybody, this is Ori from AsterWeb. In today's video, I'm going to introduce the Shopify built-in abandoned cart functionality. So before we actually introduce it and give a few tips about it, what is abandoned cart? An abandoned cart is when a customer comes to your store, your shop, they add something to the cart and they don't buy, right? Very, very simple. They abandon the cart. They abandon the potential order that they made. Now, as a store, you don't want people to, your customers to abandon the cart. You want to make sure that they can actually buy. So you want to actually figure out why they're abandoning that and then improving things. So you have two main things you can do. Number one is you can actually improve the site specific, then site experience, right? So for example, number one, you have to figure out why customers are abandoning. So are prices too high? Are they comparing? Are they finding things differently, better on competitors? Do you have a technical issue? Are your shipping rates, maybe your product prices are okay, but your shipping or tax rates are too much? Is your website slow? Many, many other things. Do people not trust you? Do you not have enough reviews? Do people kind of look for a coupon, not find a coupon and proceed back, et cetera, et cetera? So this is one thing. You have to identify why people are abandoning. The second thing, which is really the role of this video, is to remind your customers to send them an email and tell them, hey, we miss you. Like, why don't you buy? Here's a coupon, or we remind you, et cetera, et cetera. So I want to show you a few things. So the first part, I'm going to step back a little bit, is figuring out why customers are abandoning. So how do you start doing that, right? First of all, you want to go to your backend, click on orders, and click on abandoned checkouts. And there's going to be a list of customer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and all of the abandoned checkouts. Now, I'm not showing you this because this is a live site, but once you click on one of the rows, you'll see something like this. And this specific row is what I abandoned a cart for this video, so you can see this. And you can start looking at what's common. You can sample one by one. You're going to go one by one by one. You're going to look at what's common to the people who abandon their cart. Is it things from a certain country, pricing? Do they have many products in their cart? Some products are certain categories. Are their shipping rates too high, et cetera, et cetera. You're going to start looking at what the common things are, and you're going to start improving things on the site, pricing differently, changing the design, making things faster, looking at your competitors' pricing, et cetera, et cetera. So you're going to start figuring that out. The other thing you can do is you can actually go to Google Analytics, if you know what you're doing, go to e-commerce shopping behavior, and you can look at the funnel, right? You can see how many people visit your site, how many people view a product, add to cart, check out, and actually buy. And you can start looking at the people that, for example, you can look at the segments, the people that are in, what's common for the people who are viewing products but not adding to their cart. So you can click here, create a new segment, for example, product views, for this video, right, for this. And then you can make a segment, right? And you can, this is a segment right here. I made a segment, and every single report I'm going to look at, for example, mobile devices or traffic sources or technology or which products they viewed, et cetera, you can start looking at that data. And once you start looking at the data, you can figure out what's in common and then start making changes to the site. Going back to the original part of the video, let's figure out how to notify customers to remind them that they abandoned the cart and try to get some of them to actually order. So how do you do this? Number one, you have to make sure that your site is actually set up. So first of all, you go to settings and you go to checkout, and you're going to scroll down to the abandoned cart, and you're going to make sure that this is automatically checked. This will make Shopify automatically send an email every, in this case, 10 hours, right? These are the settings, and to anyone who will abandon the cart or only email subscribers. So typically, this is the best default setup you want to have. This video is going to explain that you should also experiment with things, right? So Shopify recommends 10 hours, but sometimes what you can do is you can do A/B testing. You can let it run for a month or two or a few weeks, depending on how much traffic you have. And you can change the settings, for example, here, and click on save, and you can see how many people actually recover their cart. And we'll show some reports a little bit later. The other thing you can do, and probably the biggest thing you can do aside from changing the settings, is customize the email. So if you click here, this is how an email looks that the customer gets, in this case, after 10 hours that they abandoned the cart. Looks pretty boring, nothing special. You can improve that by changing, putting images, putting logos, potentially adding a coupon. A lot of businesses add a coupon, say, hey, 10% off, here you go, etc. So how do you do that? Now, number one, if you're not a developer, you probably don't want to touch it, but I'm going to explain the basic concept here, okay? If you need, go find a developer, let them do this, release any basic developer that knows Shopify or HTML, they can pretty quickly do this, or very, very quickly. So what are we going to do? So let's see here. So the things you want to experiment were, first, the email subject line, right? The email subject, which is pretty boring, complete your purchase. So you can say, hey, we miss you. Here's a coupon. You abandoned your cart. Did you forget something? Many, many other things, right? So you can start experimenting one by one with these things, figure out when people are actually recovering their emails more. And the second thing is you can change the actual content. So the content itself is using liquid code, right? So it's using a lot of these things that if you're not a developer, especially for Shopify, you don't know what that is. If you're not sure, don't touch it. But in general, if I want to add some content, for example, I made a promotion right here. Let's say I made a promotion and I called it 10% off for anyone who abandons carts. Just for example, 10 off cart. Okay, I would create 10% off, apply it to everybody, and I would click on save. Once I do that, I can actually go to my template and find the place I want to insert. So for example, here, let's just say I want to put it right here. No, it's just, this is just an example, or visit your store. So I would go here, click here, visit our store. Okay, for example, and I would put it right here. You know, or etc. Once you do this, I would say, for example, here's a coupon for you, and I would click save. Okay, I'm not going to do this because it's a live site. And after I click on save, I would send a test. I can preview, and I would send a test email to my inbox. If everything looks good, I let it run, gather data, and I go and try to figure out what is actually getting people to recover more often. Okay, the last part. The last part is figuring out reports. So how do you get to reports? You're going to go to the marketing. As soon as it's enabled and it's running for a while, you're going to go to your marketing and you're going to go to your automations, right? Right here, or you can see on the overview. And you can see the abandoned cart checkout right here. I can click on report, and I can see the data. How often within the time frame that I selected did I actually recover carts? So for example, I've sent many emails back. I've got 51 of them to actually click back to my website to add it to cart, and I had 6 orders, for example. Here's my data. So what you want to do is when you experiment with the email subject emails and the content, et cetera, and of course the coupons, if you do decide, you can actually start comparing them. You can change the date switcher. So for example, every 7 days or every 28 days, I might change it. I can go let data gather and figure out why people are actually recovering and what can I improve more. So hope this makes sense for you. If you have any questions, let me know. Again, this video is only for Shopify default, and there's other apps that do more interesting things like multiple follow-up emails, track the open rates of just reading the email, not just clicking on the email. There's many, many other things, but this is the default Shopify functionality. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much. Appreciate you watching our videos. Thank you very much.